I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Let's see, are you a boy or a girl? It's a boy.
A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. Our beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly.
Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up. You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're James? Just a...
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move, move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
Just remember one thing. We need a doctor, not a dead one.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations, no, and there will be no repercussions.
The James and his cheery charity.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
Toys. Don't look straight into the light, pal.
Just like home.
You'll hurt your eyes. It's just something you get used to down here. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to Daddy. Come to Daddy. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Mama?
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pen you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible, Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amara wants to play.
Experiment to prepare. Prepare to survive.
Of course, I miss her. I miss her.
Surprise! Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your mother...
Congratulations, young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. You're such a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than me and Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
I wish I was 10. Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
What, are you two best friends now? Hey, Wally, I think Paul's gone soft on us.
Enjoying yourself?
Yeah, Paul. Why don't you introduce us to your new best friend?
Nice party, butthead. Now get lost.
How's it going, pal?
Oh, my mom made me come to your stupid party. Don't expect me to hang out with you. Get lost, loser.
Happy birthday! How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Sure, most people don't give a thought to their Pip-Boy as long as it keeps working. Well, anyway, I got this for your birthday. It isn't much, and you probably already have one. But there you go. Happy birthday.
How's it going, pal?
So, what do you think we should call
Dad,
our game?
I told you not
totally
to act
killer,
all
though.
Official. Hey, I know you were joking, rollers? But I'm not sure anyone else did.
Who wants to go around
enjoying yourself?
People always enjoy
sometimes
my
I
little
I think you really
speeches.
Are as dumb as
besides,
you
besides, that friend of yours can use a reminder.
Come on, Wally. You always have good ideas.
Games.
Ugh, this is supposed to be a party.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amata put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Cool, right?
Jeez, Wally.
Another
the
youth
gang?
Well
you
on
me?
His way
no
to
way.
Becoming
think
a productive Vault citizen.
I'm sure of it, Amata. Never suspected a thing.
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Such a nice, polite young man you are. Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here. Here you go. A nice, sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
Now go on and enjoy yourself.
Hey, happy birthday, Nosebleed.
Thanks for coming, Sammy. I know you were busy with the
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Water purifier. It's fine, I hope.
Get lost, butt
oh,
breath.
Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
I wasn't
having
worried.
A good time?
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Ugh, I don't want your nerd cooties. You're gonna be sorry you did that. We'll see how tough you are later when the grown-ups aren't around.
Butch is such an idiot. Just ignore him. I know. He thinks he's so tough. One of these days, we'll figure out a way to get him back, okay?
Wasn't easy keeping this a secret. Now go on. I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to
you. Somebody's got to have a better idea than those.
I help with the decorations, you know.
How about Hell's overseers?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
They're lovely.
I like that.
You did such a
splendid
job. Well,
at least it doesn't have your name in it somewhere. Which makes it better
birthday.
Than any of your other ideas.
We're all sat down here.
I'm sure you've had quite enough old lady chit-chat.
I'm glad to be here.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people. As part of my...
Just because I came to your party doesn't
like
mean I have to talk to you.
Sure thing, Officer Gomez.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. Of course you're not five. You're a big 10-year-old man now, aren't you? With your very own Pip-Boy. And do you know what I did? Just for the occasion, wrote you a poem. I hope you like it. No, really. I wrote it just for you. I'd never just copy one of my old poems. Well, there was that one Founders Day where I couldn't rhyme anything with overseer. But you deserve nothing less than a brand new poem. You can keep it in your Pip-Boy and read it whenever you want.
Well, it's been nice chatting with you. Thanks again for coming. Thank you for coming, Miss Beatrice.
Whoa,
I hope you're having a nice time.
Now, quick.
Oh my goodness! I wouldn't have missed it for the world.
I don't know.
That dear boy is like a...
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself. Your dad is waiting to give you your...
Are you ready for your surprise? Since when? Regardless, I think you'll like this one. You're getting older, and you've got your Pip-Boy. I figure you're old enough for this, too. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? Easy now. It's only a BB gun, but it's not a toy. Let's go try it out. Jonas and I have found a nice spot for you. Follow me.
Present. Or should we just keep it?
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Good work. That's one less round roads to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter. Good work. Let's get a pic.
Stand next to your dad and smile.
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is your problem anyway? So I'm the overseer's daughter. Gloria. So what? That like I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
As I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. No, you're not. Really. When I started studying medicine, one of the first things I learned was how to spot a kid playing sick to get out of taking a test. You'll do fine. It's not so bad. Everyone has to take it when they're 16. I had to, you have to, and so does everyone else. And most everyone makes it through without a scratch. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh?
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Amata?
Daddy's girl.
Go run
daddy's
and tell your
girl.
Daddy on us? She thinks she's better than
Get
us.
Get these idiots away from me!
You think you're special? Tunnel snakes rule. Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us tunnel snakes. We can't have that. Because we're the tunnel snakes, and we rule. That's us, and we rule. No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to Butch and Wally. You don't want to be on their bad sides. Trust me. None of your business, because Butch said so. And what Butch says goes. Tunnel snakes rule! You got that right. Better not forget it either. Much later, tunnel snakes rule! Special because your daddy is the over...
Don't mess with the tunnel snakes. What? You mouthing off, Spaz? Everyone knows the tunnel snakes. We rule this vault, and we don't take shit from nobody. Not you, not her, and not her daddy, the overseer. Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch were just having some fun with this chick. I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the tunnel snakes is where I belong. Why? You think Butch is in charge? Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying. What? What kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here.
Seer?
We're done here.
Done? We're not done. I say when we're done.
Don't know who put you in charge. I say we're done. Let's go, Paul.
Are you sure? Butch? Okay. Whatever you say, Wally. Tunnel snakes rule. Fine, let's go. I was done here anyway. This ain't over, Daddy's girl. I'm not finished with you either, twerp.
Thank God.
Don't mess with the tunnel, Snake.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Yes, I think I'd like that. Will it take long?
Oh, shouldn't it take long? I just need to get things set up for you. Just sit tight.
This isn't over, punk. This isn't over, punk. Hey, Susie, what's new?
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. Listen, I like your dad. I might even like you if I wasn't your teacher. So here's what I'm going to do. If you want to skip the test, just tell me how you want it to come out, and I'll take care of it for you. Well, all right. Here, take a look.
A clean vault is a healthy vault. Please place all trash into the appropriate incineration receptacle on your scheduled burning day.
Take your seat so we can get started.
What is it, Phoebe?
Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat.
Do you mind? I'm trying to pay attention.
Do you mind? I know to you it's just meaningless jabber, but I'm actually trying to teach you.
Daddy Mr. Brotz. Right here to save you now. Is he? Get back to work. Selfish and insubordinate. Just like
you need to know.
Wake
this.
Up! Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! Aren't you listening? Your dad is gone! From the vault! He opened the main door and left! My father has completely flipped out. I've never seen him like this. He ordered the guards to beat Jonas to death. And now they're looking for you! I'm sorry, he's dead. They beat him, they just wouldn't stop. And my father ordered them to do it. I snuck out to warn you as soon as they were gone. I don't know! Some of my father's men? Look, that doesn't matter right now. You need to worry about getting out of here alive. Revenge will have to wait. Good, you're finally talking sense. My God, this is all so crazy. I can't believe your dad didn't tell you he was leaving. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there.
Criminy, more roaches.
Holy smokes, that was close.
Get up.
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! Please! I know I've always been a jerk towards you. I know it! But you can't walk away and let her die just because I was an asshole. Please! I'm begging you! Sure, I don't care why. Just get her out of there.
Come on, sit down and have a drink.
We did it! mom's gonna be okay. You're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
With me.
You're the one everybody's looking for, right? Well, it's none of my business. Your dad always took good care of us.
For a spot of fresh air. Should be back any moment, I imagine.
Why don't you look where you're going?
Just hold still. Your left stabilizer's been knocked loose.
I am holding still. It's your pulsing hands that are shaking.
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me, Tom Holt.
and leave, didn't he? He had to mess things up for everybody.
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself. I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault. Let's let history be the judge of that. If you had paid attention to Mr. Brotch, you'd understand that history is invariably written by the victor.
And I intend to be the victor. You won't survive the night. Guards, help me!
What have you done? You killed him! Why would you kill my father? opened it. Good, you're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you... You didn't have to kill him! So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No! Don't listen to me. Just go! Find your father! I have to go bury mine! You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.